Hello and welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for joining us today. In studio today, we have for this health supplier segment, Ms. Tricia Page. She's senior director with the J-Screen program at Emory University in Atlanta, Georgia. Now, after receiving her Bachelor in Science in Genetics from the University of Georgia, she received her master's degree in genetic counseling from the University of Texas Health Center, Health Science Center in Houston. Now, in 1996, and her certification from the American Board of Medical Genetics in 1999. She's here today with us to talk about the J-Screen program and let us know exactly what it's all about and the role that she plays in it. How are you doing this afternoon, Tricia?
Great. Thanks so much for having me.
Thank you so much. J-Screen, as I said, it's a program run out of Emory University in Atlanta, Georgia. What exactly is J-Screen?
Yeah, so J-Screen is a public health program, like you said, run out of Emory University, and our mission is to promote screening, specifically carrier screening that can be done like before pregnancy, and hopes of preventing diseases that occur more commonly in the Jewish population. The J in J-Screen, obviously, is because we're focusing most of our marketing and outreach into the Jewish community, so we absolutely... If you have even one Jewish grandparent, it's important to have screening done before pregnancy. It's also, though, something that really every group is at risk for something. And it's important that really everyone have screening done. And while we are, everyone who's planning a pregnancy, not everyone in the world, but, you know, if you're planning a pregnancy, definitely you should consider having what's called expanded carrier screening. And that can give you really valuable information to help you plan for a healthy family.
Expanded carrier screening. Is that any different than any other screening that's going on?
Well, so in the past, people have been screened for, say, one condition. So if you were African American, you were screened for like sickle cell disease. Caucasian women may be screened for something like cystic fibrosis. But it's really amazing, Neil. The technology has advanced to where, like in our program at J-Screen, we actually screen for over 100 different conditions on a single test.
On one single test?
Yeah, and it's just a saliva test, too. You don't even have to get blood anymore.
So it's not invasive at all?
No. In fact, the way J-Screen works is we actually mail the kit. You know, we get a doctor's orders because that's required, and then we mail a kit to people's houses so they don't even have to go into the doctor. And then when the results are ready, we have board-certified, licensed genetic counselors that will explain those to a couple and talk about what their options are. Most of the time, it's reassuring news, thankfully. But if it's not, then they at least have the information and can plan.
Now, you say over 100 different conditions are screened on one test. Are we talking about everything from, say, cancer to diabetes? Are we talking about these types of diseases?
Right. So that's a great question. So, no. The conditions that we are talking about are those that a person might unknowingly pass on to their children. So these are things like cystic fibrosis, sickle cell disease. The condition, testing for the conditions that you're talking about, cancer, Alzheimer's, diabetes, in some situations, genetic testing is available for those, but for most people, like kind of garden variety, you know, cancer, Alzheimer's, we just don't know what all the genetic components are yet. So we are pretty focused on looking at reproductive health and not really like personal health information.
Now, how long has the J-Screen program been operating out of Emory University?
Yeah, so happily we've been around. We just celebrated our second birthday in September, so we're a relatively young program.
And you say you have genetic counselors. Now, are these counselors, do they come straight from Emory? Are they trained specifically, you know, by J-Screen for J-Screen's efforts, or can anyone who would like to be a genetic counselor simply put in an application to J-Screen?
Right. So that's a great question. So all of our counseling now is done either through the laboratory that we use or through Emory. And so as our volume grows, though, we certainly, you know, expect that we'll need additional genetic counselors. And so, yeah, I mean, I'm always happy to hear from people who are interested. You know, there are not enough genetic counselors out there for, you know, to handle all the needs. So if there's someone specifically interested in this, then, yeah, I would absolutely love to hear from them.
Now, with the sweeping changes in healthcare coverage, is this testing covered, say, by healthcare, by your regular run-of-the-mill healthcare, or do you have to have some type of special coverage in order just to take this test?
Right. So for many people, it is covered, but we know that that's a fear that a lot of people have and might keep them from having testing. And so, you know, at least through our program, what we do is we just charge a $99 program fee.
Okay.
And that covers the test, that covers your genetic counseling, basically everything related to it. Okay. And so even if your insurance pays nothing, then all all people who come through our program are ever going to pay is the $99.
Ah, okay. And as we wrap up, are you working on anything current to enhance the services that you already provide?
Yeah, so, you know, we are, we're constantly, you know, thinking about additional conditions that we might add onto it's amazing. The field of genetics is changing so fast that we're constantly learning and adding. And it wouldn't surprise me if in the next year or so we're screening for, you know, more than 104 conditions.
Now, what's the main the biggest misconception about J-Screen that you'd like to clear up for our listeners today?
Yeah, I think that that people sometimes think if you have this kind of genetic testing, then, you know, if you get news that's difficult to hear, then we're going to say you shouldn't have children, or you know, what are you going to do? You don't have options. But actually, there are many options for couples today. For, you know, to go on and have healthy children. And the technologies are, you know, more affordable and more accessible than really ever before. So it's really information that you can use in a very practical way.
Great, great. And where can our listeners get much more information about J-Screen and Emory University?
Yeah, so it's really easy. Just go to jscreen.org. And there's information there, as well as a contact us, and we'll be happy to answer any questions.
Great, great. Thank you so much for joining us today, Tricia.
Thank you for having me.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. It's been a pleasure talking in studio today with Ms. Tricia Pate, Senior Director with the J-Screen Program at Emory University in Atlanta, Georgia. And in her current position, she's focusing on improving the delivery of genetic services from both an individual and public health perspective, especially in the realm of preconception carrier screening. She is the senior director with J-Screen, as I said, and she's actually educating the community about the importance of genetic screening to help keep future families healthy. It's been great having you here today.
Thank you so much.
Transcripts and audio of this program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au. And also at hpr.fm, and you can subscribe to our podcast on iTunes.